Good morning, children. Welcome to computer science class. Okay, last class, what all things we have learned? Yes, computer parts are divided into main parts and helping parts. What are the main parts of computer? Monitor, keyboard, mouse, and CPU. What are the helping parts of computer? Printer, joystick, and speakers. These are the helping parts of computer. Then how many main parts are there for a computer? Yes, four main parts. Computer has four main parts. These, what is the difference between main part and helping part? Main parts are important parts. Any one of these is not working or not available, we couldn't work with computer. Helping parts support computer to do different jobs, like printer take print out, then speaker emit sound, joystick help us to play games, etc. There are so many helping parts are available, but in this chapter we have to study only three helping parts. And today we are going to study another important thing. Parts of computer is again divided into input devices and output devices. Today we are going to study input devices and output devices with examples. Are you ready? Okay. Let us go to class. Dear children, what are things that we have learned last class? Input, different parts of computer, right? What are the different parts of computer? Monitor, keyboard, mouse, and CPU are the main parts of computer. And there are some other parts that is called helping parts, okay? Helping parts help the computer to do some special functions, okay? So parts of computer is mainly divided into two: main parts and helping parts. There are four main parts, and they are keyboard, mouse, CPU, and monitor. Then example for helping parts are printer, speaker, and joystick. Understand? I hope you have written all the notes. I have given you some new words like monitor. What is the spelling of monitor? M-O-N-I-T-O-R, monitor. Then keyboard, K-E-Y-B-O-A-R-D, keyboard. Mouse, M-O-U-S-E, mouse. Joystick, J-O-Y-S-T-I-C-K, joystick. Printer, P-R-I-N-T-E-R, printer. Speaker, S-P-E-A-K-E-R, speaker. Every day, daily, you have to practice these words orally 10 times and then write and study 3 times. Okay, 3 times you have to write and study, and also you have to do oral practice. All these words are little tough, and so you have to practice regularly. Understand, children? So today we are going to study input and output devices. Can you see the picture? Yes. What is that girl doing? She is helping her mother to make juice. See, you all like juice, right? Okay. So, for making orange juice, what all things we need? Yes, we need some oranges, then sugar, water, or milk, right? And we give oranges, water, and sugar into the mixie. Mixie blend it. Mixie blend it. And we get tasty juice, right? So who does all these things? Mixie, right? Mixie process all these things. What are things that we have given? Oranges, sugar, and water. And what we get? We get juice, tasty juice, right? So the same thing happen in the case of computer also. We have to give some instructions. If you want to get any result from computer, or if you want to make the computer do something, first we have to give instructions. If you want to make the computer to do something, first we have to give some commands or instructions or data. Okay, that is called input. That is called input. So the data given to the computer is called input. Okay, is input. Data given to the computer is called input. Keyboard. Keyboard help us to give instruction to the computer. Mouse is also help us to give instruction to the computer. So these devices are called, these parts are called input devices. So what is the use of input devices? What is the duty of input devices? Input devices help us to give input to the computer. Namukku computer like input kodukkan. Input means what? Data, instruction or instructions or commands, right? Appo ingenta commands allengil nammalde jobs computer like kodukkan help cheyana devices ineyana nammal endu parayanathu input devices nu parayanathu. Nammal kodukkana ingenta data ne nammal endha paraya input. We give input to the computer using input devices. We give input to the computer using input devices. Keyboard is an example of input device. Mouse is an example of input device. Then microphone is an example of input device. What is input? The data given to the computer is called input. Then what is data? Endha ee data nu parna nammal kodukana numbers. Nammal type cheyyula keyboard use cheyidu nammal letters type cheyyum numbers type cheyyum. Sometimes we scan and give images, sounds, sometimes videos. Okay, see, these are called data. The things that we give to the computer is called data or input. And for giving data and or input to the computer, we need some devices called input devices. The devices which we use to give input to the computer is called input devices. The devices which we use to give input to the computer is called input devices. Can you see the examples? Yes, keyboard is an example, joystick, mouse, all these are called input devices. These devices are used to give input to the computer. Clear, children? Okay, take your textbook. Okay, page number 14. Are you ready to read? Keep finger under the letters. Shall we read? Okay, fine. All the parts of the computer have different functions. All the parts of computer have different functions. That means different. All the parts of computer, all the parts of computer have different uses or different duties. Function means duty. Okay, so what's the spelling of function? FUNCTIONS. Parts or devices of a computer which are used to give the input and show the output can be classified as input devices and output devices. Input devices. What is an input? Data within bracket P, numbers within bracket, you can see numbers, letters or pictures entered into a computer is called input. So what is input? Data entered into the computer is called input, and the input may be or data may be numbers, letters or pictures. Numbers, letters or pictures or sound. Clear? Okay. Input can be fed in the computer through keyboard, mouse, joystick, etc. Input can be fed in the computer through keyboard, mouse, joystick, etc. Such devices are called input devices. Keyboard. We can give input to the computer by using the keyboard. The text we type on the keyboard is shown on the monitor. So what you have to do is read this page three times. Okay? No other homeworks. Only this much for today. Thank you so much. Bye.